So Ilja, hi.
How's it going?
We are here on the Gamechanger audio booth, and you've got a new pedal. Which,
right.
You know, to some guitarists might look familiar, but they don't usually see this sort of thing on the floor, right?
That's correct, yeah. It's the unmistakable look of a Bigsby system. But yeah, this one is digital.
Okay, cool. So talk us through exactly what's happening and what we can hear from it.
So this pedal, the most obvious use case for this pedal is like this pedal allows you to get the Bigsby and vibrato arm functionality on hardtail guitars, as well as other instruments such as acoustic guitars, banjos, mandolins, bass, and all the other usual suspects that cannot physically have a vibrato system.
So even the synthesizer?
Well, I mean, the sound quality is there. You can even shift a whole track, or you can shift your vocal signal, or your polyphonic synth, or stuff like that. But obviously, a lot of synthesizers already have pitch shifting, built in the form of a pitch wheel or a pitch envelope or stuff like that. You don't actually need to pitch shift
nice
the audio output. You know, you need to. But yeah, you might want to do that as well.
Brilliant. So should we hear a bit of it first then?
Yeah. Okay. So. The most basic use case is just doing this, right? What I like to do, for example, I kind of mentioned that already. So the basic use case, the obvious use case, is to provide a replacement for a Bigsby system to guitars that don't have one. But that's only scratching the surface, because the range of the pedal can go from a quarter tone up to an octave. You can blend in the dry signal and use it as a harmonizer. And there's a built-in LFO, so you can do weird effects. So, and then, but even if we don't touch any knobs right now, just this, like I've got it set up at a full tone downwards interval. Where it becomes interesting is that I can use it to change my playing patterns and my playing habits. For example, I can do a continuous picking pattern like. I can start my note at a lower frequency. So instead of sliding into notes, I can. And that's something that's really, really cool. Once you get the foot, get the mechanics going. So naturally, good guitar players are able to do crazy, crazy things with these kind of. With these tricks. Or, for example, I can. One thing I can do with the pedal is I can. There's a switch at the back. If I lift that switch, now the upwards interval. Is fixed to this part of the pedal. So I'll do it here as well. So now I'll be able to do. So I can do things like double bends, for example. So I, as a guitarist, I find that really, really exciting. There's it's a subtle thing, but it opens up a lot of possibilities for really, really expressive and new playing. So you can imitate like lap steel guitars and slide guitars and do crazy, crazy, crazy things. So like that was the main motivation behind behind building this. So,
what other features have we got? Have we got any kind of like what inputs, etc. have we got?
Right. So input, output. That's straightforward. This is an expression pedal. This is a double function like output that can serve as an expression out or as a foot switch in. So here we've got a foot switch plugged into this connector. That means when I can plug in any type of guitar foot switch, like, and now the pedal is just like an octave or something. It's just on, so. Right. That's useful if you want to do like a passage where you just go, if you just want to drop the guitar a few, so just. So that way you don't have to keep, you know, holding the foot down or something like that. So that's one. And then if you have this, if you plug in expression if you plug in the TRS cable into this and send it to an expression input on a different pedal, then you can use this lever, this like kind of spring-loaded lever, as an expression controller for other effects.
Oh, brilliant! So and so, I guess it could work. Yeah, you could be doing two effects or multiple effects with that just that one switch.
So the depth of the Bigsby, it like you can set it up so it goes all the way down to zero. So for example, here if I turn it all the way down to zero, that will happen. So the upwards interval is here on the red layer of the knobs. So nothing will happen, but it will still send a control signal via the expression jack. So this way I can like connect it to, let's say, to the light pedal and change the speed of the tremolo or the sweep, or I can connect it into a filter and go like wow, like do stuff like that. And if you long press this button, you enter a setup menu where you get to set up the range and the center point and the direction of the expression pedal. Like, so I think it's actually really cool that like you can use it just as a spring-loaded expression pedal if the depth is turned all the way down. So we're definitely going to be making some videos with that functionality. So yeah, and then also at the back there is a small 3.5 millimeter MIDI connector.
Right. Okay.
That means so you can access all parameters of the pitch shift algorithm that's in here with CC and PC messages. So you can map that to any controller, and you can save 10 preset slots, recall 10 preset slots with like very simple in a very simple way. Like if you send message one, you recall like the first preset. Send message two, you recall the second preset. If you want to save something on the slot three, you send PC message 13. So so if you want to save on slot one, you send 11. On slot two, you send 12, and then to recalls, go 1, 2, or 3 up to 10. So you can save 10 presets and then control all aspects of the pitch shift like algorithm via MIDI. So. It is primarily a guitar pedal, but we've developed a really powerful real-time pitch shifting algorithm, which actually is surprisingly, like, it's in our opinion, it's really, really, really powerful. So I would not be surprised if this pedal would find a place in your studio setup, controlling and pitch shifting some kind of tracks in real time, or pitch shifting vintage synths or something like that.
Brilliant.
Yeah.
Wow. So when are you hoping to have this kind of ready to go? Is it kind of near the end of the production cycle, or do you have
this has been out for a few months, but we keep selling out.
So, right, okay.
So there might be moments where it's out of stock, but it is in production continuously. We are being affected a little bit by the chip shortage, which is something I'm sure you've heard a lot.
Of course, yeah.
But this one uses the Shark audio, like microcontrollers, so the situation is a little bit better.
Brilliant.
But yeah, they're out. It's $379 US, and yeah.
Excellent.
And just the best way to learn more about this and get one for yourself is to go to gamechangeraudio.com.
Brilliant. Well, Ilja, yeah. Thank you very much.
Thanks a lot. All right. Thanks for watching.